Good evening and welcome to Art Keller Field of Carthage College in Kenosha, Wisconsin for tonight's game between the Carthage Firebirds and the North Park Vikings. Tonight is the final home game for the Carthage women this season, and that means it is senior night. And so we're just about to get underway here shortly with the ceremony to celebrate our five seniors who are going to be honored tonight, who will be coming out with their parents. And we'll be introduced to them as the evening goes on. Just wanted to mention those five seniors right off the top. Those five seniors graduating this year are Jenny Garcia, Zyra Solis, Annika Schmidt, Kenzie Zucker, and Olivia Covelli. So those five seniors all graduating, they all have big plans for after graduation, which they've shared with us, and they may talk about a little bit during the ceremony as well. So we'll get to all of them tonight and talk a little bit about their great contributions to Carthage over the years. As you can not quite see on screen right now, but the team is coming out to line up, getting ready for the seniors to be celebrated. And it will be a good game tonight, too. Carthage looking for its first win on the season, 0-7-5 so far on the season, playing North Park, which is 3-8-2. They're very similar in their conference records as well, 0-4-1 for Carthage, 1-3-1 for North Park. So it will be an important battle in terms of the conference tonight as well. But tonight, as I mentioned, really all about those seniors. They're getting ready to take the field here, as you can see. There you have the team lined up and Coach Wilson lined up there with some flowers for the seniors. They'll be coming out with their parents, which is always a nice occasion for these seniors and for the whole Carthage squad. Five of them graduating this year. As I mentioned, they've all got big plans. Four of the five are planning to go on for master's degrees, and that certainly bodes well for the Carthage team. They are very strong academically as well as on the soccer pitch, so it's nice to celebrate not only their achievements on the pitch tonight, but also their parents who have raised them and gotten them to this point, and also to talk a little bit about what some of their academic interests are and what some of their plans are for the future. They certainly are bright for them and for the rest of the Carthage players coming up in this game. These two teams met last season, and Carthage won that one. It was right here at Art Keller Field last year as well. Carthage won the game 5-2 last season, behind four goals from Morgan Verbetten, who has since graduated, but she had four goals in that contest. So that's interesting in terms of thinking about what may happen this season. Obviously not the same players that are back. And interestingly, North Park has gone with a real international strategy. They've got many players this season from Sweden. Many, many players on their roster from Sweden who we'll hear about tonight. I'll try to pronounce their names as best that I can. And they've also got some young players from Norway as well that have come into the program recently. So some Scandinavian influence tonight that we'll hear on the North Park roster going against Carthage. As I mentioned, Carthage looking for their first win of the season. They're coming off a loss most recently to Wheaton on the weekend. They lost 1-0 to Wheaton. That was a tough-fought game, but unfortunately they did come out on the losing side. North Park, on the other hand, is coming off a loss against Illinois Wesleyan. That was a game lost was 5-2. Before that, they lost to North Central, who Carthage has also recently played. They lost to them 6-1. Carthage only lost to them 2-0. So North Park has shipped out 11 goals in their last two games, so that maybe bodes well for Carthage. Carthage has only given up three goals in their last two games, although they haven't been able to get on the scoreboard yet. So we're just about to start this ceremony. I think we're less than a minute away, so I'll hand it over now to the PA announcer, who will come up shortly and introduce our five seniors for the evening. Then we'll be followed by the player introductions and by kickoff shortly after that.
Ladies and gentlemen, today is senior day for the Carthage women's soccer team. Carthage Athletics would like to take a few minutes to recognize our five seniors playing in their last home game tonight. Our first senior is Jenny Garcia. Garcia is from Aurora, Illinois, and is escorted today by her father, Arturo, and mother, Adela Alfaro. Garcia has played in 30 games for the Firebirds, registering 10 shots, and plans to get her master's in education. She would also love to work with an ESSL program. Our next senior is Zyra Solis. Solis is from Batavia, Illinois, and is accompanied today by her parents, Bertha and David. Solis has played in 40 games for the Firebirds women's soccer team, registering 7 shots and 2 shots on goal. Upon graduation, she plans to continue school, getting a master's degree in industrial organizational psychology. Our next senior is Yuvia Ontiveros. Ontiveros is from Aurora, Illinois, and is escorted today by her mother Lucy, father Jorge, brother Jorge, and sister Amy. Ontiveros has played in 30 games for the Firebirds, scoring 1 goal during the 2021 season and tallying 12 total shots. She will graduate with a finance and economics degree. She plans on working as a financial analyst after graduation. Our next senior is Kenzie Zocker. Zocker is from Middleton, Wisconsin, and is accompanied today by her mother, Cindy, and Terry. Zocker has played in 18 games, scoring 3 career goals, 28 shots, and 13 shots on goal. Zocker is an art education and studio art major and plans on teaching elementary or middle school art. Our next senior is Olivia Covelli. Olivia is being escorted today by her mother, Julie. Covelli joined the team in the spring of 2022. Olivia made an immediate impact on and off the field, appearing in 4 games, starting for 3. She was a solid presence in the midfield with her voice and leadership before being sidelined with a career-ending injury. Covelli is an exercise and sports science major with plans of doing personal training after graduation. Firebird fans, please give all of our seniors one last round of applause. Thank you.
Американская фирма Transceptor Technology приступила к производству компьютеров «Персональный спутник».
Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Art Keller Field for today's game between the North Park University Vikings and your Carthage College Firebirds. Let's meet today's starting lineups. First, for the visiting Vikings. At defense, number 3, Daniel Boondock. At midfield, number 4, Kaisa Manson. At midfield, number 5, Isla Durakovic. At forward, number 8, Marta Holtgard. At forward, number 11, Ida Elise Iyela. At defense, number 13, Agnes Back. At defense, number 18, Lena Bogg. At forward, number 20, Lynn Graydon. At defense, number 23, Lydia Forsbury. At midfield, number 32, Sophie Svedberg. And in goal for the Vikings, number 1, Emily LaSalle. The head coach for North Park is Emma Woodley, and she is assisted by Kareen Cole and Ashley Meyer. And now, the starting lineup for your Carthage College Firebirds. At midfield, number 3, Jenny Garcia. At defense, number 6, Lisa Traxel. At defense, number 7, Zyra Solis. At midfield, number 9, Yuvia Ontiveros. At forward, number 12, Katie Talons. At defense, number 21, Leah Martin. At midfield, number 23, Kenzie Zocker. At defense, number 25, Stephanie Mitchell. At defense, number 28, Veronica Walker. At defense, number 29, KT Kramer. And in goal for your Firebirds, number 1, Ainsley Stallworth. The head coach for Carthage is Ian Wilson. He is assisted by Megan DeGroot and Alberto Centeno. Fans, at this time, we ask that you please rise if you are able and remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
And we're just about to get underway here for senior night. Always a nice occasion here to celebrate our seniors and all the contributions they've made to the program over the years. So nice to see that play out here on Art Keller Field this evening. It is a chilly one tonight, for sure. You can probably tell by the way that the players and the coaches, especially on the sidelines, are dressed. About 42 degrees here at kickoff, so I think the wind chill said it felt more like 38. So it is a very, very chilly night here. So the players will have to stay warm on the pitch, and certainly there's a lot of good warm feelings going around for the seniors. Nice ceremony before the game, as you hopefully got a chance there to see all the players and their parents meeting Coach Wilson, receiving some flowers and lots of praise from the Carthage fans and from their Carthage teammates as well. One substitution there in the seniors. I mentioned five seniors. There were five seniors that were honored, but the one senior that wasn't mentioned by me in the earliest part of the broadcast was Yuvia Ontiveros. Yuvia is also a senior. She's from Aurora, Illinois. She and Jenny Garcia, two of our seniors tonight, are both from Aurora. Zyra Solis is from Batavia. Kenzie Zocker is from Middleton. And Olivia Covelli, I'm not sure exactly where she's from. It doesn't say on the sheet, but congratulations to all of them for this final home game. I think most of them are going to be starting tonight, and I believe Kenzie Zocker, who has been injured, is probably, my understanding is she's going to start, but only play a very short time just to get her one last start on the pitch here. So we'll see how that plays out in the opening minutes of this game. I think, from what I understand, the plan is just to kick the ball out of bounds and to so she gets one last chance to get onto the field, which is really nice. There she is, number 23. You can see her there in the center circle with Number 28, that's Veronica Walker, who will take the kickoff. But I think they're planning to just kind of have a ceremonial kickoff here. The referee is getting ready for the game to begin, and he's signaled to his assistant referees and to the goalkeepers, and he blows his whistle. Kenzie kicks it in the center circle there, and immediately North Park does the sporting thing, plays the ball out of bounds. And Kenzie, as I mentioned, Zocker getting that final start. Very nice gesture there from both teams. Kenzie is a senior from Middleton, Wisconsin. She's an art education and studio art double major. She's planning on teaching elementary or middle school art in her professional career after college. So good luck to her. And a nice gesture here that she gets one more chance to step onto that Art Keller pitch before her college career is over. So congratulations to Kenzie, and a nice moment. Coming in for Kenzie will be sophomore Maggie Thom. She'll be playing up front with Veronica Walker, who normally plays in that kind of central striker position. Right off the bat here, North Park has the ball in the Carthage zone. They get sort of the beat there. But there was an offside on the play, according to the assistant referee, and the referee sees that now and calls it. So there was a ball in behind there that looked a little bit worrying, but apparently that player was offside. So for Carthage, the leading scorer so far on the season is Katie Talons. Katie has 4 goals on the season. She's out there tonight as one of the starters. She's number 12. Jess Beamer, who is the second leading scorer, is starting from the bench tonight, but she'll certainly get on the field at some point. I know Coach likes to especially play his seniors a little bit, although most of the seniors that are starting tonight are seniors that would normally start anyway. Up front there, that's Maggie Thom, who just came in, as I mentioned, on the substitution. She's harrying her defender there on the far side. It looks like across the back we have Lisa Traxel playing left back. Stephanie Mitchell's at left center back. I believe it is Leah Martin who's at right center back, and Zyra Solis is on that far side. Actually, I think it's Katie Kramer who's playing right center back. It looks like Leah Martin, there she is with the ball, and playing in kind of deep midfield, so just in front of the back four. Virginia Garcia, one of the seniors there, putting on some pressure. Lisa Traxel kicks it upfield. Katie Talons gives some chase on that far side. North Park's leading scorer is actually a defender, Agnes Beck, a sophomore Swedish player. She, so far on the season, has 4 goals. Lena Bog, who's also Swedish, is second on the team with 3 goals. As I mentioned, lots of Swedish players top to bottom on this North Park team. They've done a lot of recruiting in Scandinavia. And so we'll see many of those players tonight. As I mentioned, I'll try to do my best to pronounce them. I do have some Scandinavian heritage, so hopefully that will be helpful. Ainsley Stallworth in the Carthage goal. Ainsley has played every single minute for Carthage this season. Over 1,000 minutes already this season. 1,080 minutes. Her goals against averages is 1.83, which is very respectable. Carthage has not won a game yet, but they have really not been beaten badly. Their worst loss was 4-0, and that was to Illinois Wesleyan in their first CCIW game. Other than that, they've been very, very close in all of their games. Not as much the case for North Park. They have had a couple of more lopsided losses. As I mentioned, they lost 5-2 most recently to Illinois Wesleyan and 6-1 to North Central in the last 2 games. So they've been giving up a few goals here and there, especially in their most recent contest. So hopefully Carthage can take advantage of that. There's Yuva Ontiveros, another one of our seniors right in the center there. Yuva tries to go forward to Maggie Thom. It does end up way down in the far corner there. That is Maggie Thom. She tries to center it across. It's cleared out there, but not super convincingly. It's still around, although there was a foul at the back there, spotted by the assistant referee, and so that will be a free kick to North Park. North Park is coached as by Emma Woodley. She's in her third season. I believe it said she'd been with the program for six or seven, I believe. Her last season as a player at North Park was 2014, I believe I read, and she started coaching the following year as an assistant and eventually was named the head coach, and this is her third season. Coach Wilson for Carthage, Ian Wilson, is in his fourth season. So two coaches with not a lot of experience, but they're starting to settle into their respective programs. North Park with a little bit of build up here, although that's corralled fairly easily at the back by Stephanie Mitchell. She goes over to Katie Kramer, who finds Katie Talons in midfield. There's Katie again on the ball. Tries to find something going up the right-hand side, but it is blocked there. North Park coming back the other direction now through midfield. It goes all the way back to the defense. Comes across. That's Lydia. Looks like Forsberg, but I guess it's Forsberg. Must be the Swedish pronunciation. There's Durakovic now for North Park. She finds Hultgard. Tries to get it centrally back to Durakovic, but it does end up in the arms of Ainsley Stallworth. Stallworth looks upfield and boots it long downfield. Veronica Walker is there. She plays the central striker for Carthage. She's fouled on the play, and so that will be a free kick for Carthage inside the North Park zone. Taken quickly there. Tried to get it out to Katie Talons. Good effort. Leah Martin, I think, was the one who took that kick quickly. North Park having a little spell of possession here. Manson out to Hultgard. Uvia Deveras has it coming the other direction. She's tripped up there. Leah Martin is there, though. Jenny Garcia tries to find Maggie Thom up front. Maggie's kind of playing on the left side of a front two with Veronica Walker at this point. Leah Martin's kind of at the base of defense. There, Jenny Garcia, who's on the ball, is a little bit further forward, it seems. So that'll be a goal kick. Stallworth takes this one short. Trying to play out from the back. Garcia tries to go near side. That ball does end up out of bounds, so that'll be a Carthage throw. Lisa Traxel will line that one up. She finds Yuva Antiveros, who makes a nice turn there, but then loses out. Now Maggie Thom, can she get there before it goes out of bounds? She does, and steers it upfield, or nicely done. That ball went out of bounds. That will be a Carthage throw. Lisa Traxel hustles up the line to take it. She does. She finds Thom on the turn. Tried to jink it inside there to Antiveros, but it didn't quite go through. North Park now coming up this near side. Lydia Forsberry. Leah Martin stops it, though. Finds Katie Talons. Katie Kramer tries to kick it upfield, but it is intercepted by North Park. They're coming back this direction now. But a nice defensive play there. Now Carthage has a little bit of space to run here. Maggie Thom coming through the middle. Nice run. Got a beat on it. Oh, she couldn't quite get there, but a really nice pass and a good, really good run by Maggie. Thom up this near side. Maggie's a sophomore from Rochester, Minnesota. Rochester Lawrence High School. Now North Park coming the other way, a little counterattack here. This game is pretty spread out at the moment. Hulkard with a shot from distance, and it does go wide. That was about, you know, a good 30 yards out or so. And Ainsley Stallworth just let it go past her post. She was very comfortable that that was going to go wide, and so she didn't play it. Hulkard there with the interception, although it does end up coming back to Jenny Garcia. Goes back to Traxel. Tries to go upfield, but it does go out of bounds. That'll be another throw in. The referee restarts play. A little equipment malfunction there, I think, maybe. Reason for that stoppage. So Lise tries to play it out to Talon, so you can't quite catch up to it. It's Lynn Graydon on that side. She makes a nice play. But an equally nice play by Katie Kramer to intercept that ball. Nicely done there. Martin and Zyra Solis team up for a little defense there and ends up going out of bounds. Throw in North Park. Try to come near side. Up into the middle. Leah Martin is there though. She's strong in the middle of that defensive midfield. A little back heel pass nicely done there. Now she'll try to go for that return pass. That was Hulkard, number 8. Ball's kicked out of bounds there, but it will be a throw rather than a corner kick. It did go over the sideline as opposed to the end line. And on the return pass, Hulkard was offside. So she threw the ball in, and then when she got it back, she was behind the second to last defender. So that is an offside call. The referee standing right there on the scene. Carthage having trouble getting much possession here. North Park has probably had a little bit more so far in terms of possession. Just the one shot so far, and that did come from North Park. Although here comes Maggie Thom up the middle. She's got a breakaway here. Oh, the keeper came out nicely defended there by the keeper. That's Emily LaSalle. LaSalle had to be there because Maggie Thom had a good run there. She was pretty much all alone. There were two defenders challenging her, but they were behind her a couple of steps, so couldn't quite get it over the keeper. So a nice goal-saving save by Emily LaSalle. There's a foul on the field there, so that'll be a free kick to Carthage. So that was the first shot, and the first shot on goal for Carthage. That was definitely an opportunity. A real nice play by the keeper, Emily LaSalle. Emily has been their number one goalkeeper so far this season. She's got 750 minutes. Two other keepers have played this season, but she's played in 9 games. Here comes Carthage up front again. A little bit of a bouncing ball in the middle there. There might be a little injury timeout here. One of the players took a close-range header to the head. referees are always very cautious with anything approaching a head injury, so they'll have the staff come out and just make sure that the protocols are followed and wouldn't want anybody playing with any kind of a potential head injury or anything like that. So the training staff has come out to check on the player, and it looks like she may go off. Not sure if there'll be a substitution or if she'll just take a quick breather on the sidelines and come back on to the field of play. We'll see. I think there was an immediate substitution there anyway. And it looks like Holtgard is back on the field, so that's good news. Just a little bit of a close range blow, as I mentioned. It came to the Carthage player, she headed it, and it went immediately off of the head of Holtgard, so she just went down in a little bit of pain, but she's back up and has been checked out and is back on the field now. So that's good. Never want to see an injury. Guys are trying to go forward again. This time Veronica Walker making a run into the area. Jenny Garcia picks it up just outside the 18-yard box. She brings it back to her left foot and shoots. It bounced right before the keeper. A decent shot. Emily LaSalle had to be alert to that one. It did get to the goal and on a bounce, so that's a second shot for Carthage. Well done there. Getting a little bit of offensive pressure here now, trying to finding some through balls and getting past that last line of defense for North Park. Out of bounds on that far side. North Park player picked it up as if she was going to throw it in, but it was in fact a Carthage throw-in, so it is taken over there by Zyra Solis. There's a foul there. Rather than an out-of-bounds, I think that'll be a free kick, so it looks like Carthage may put a few players in the box here, and they may try to get something into that danger area. So we're past the 15-minute mark here, 29 minutes remaining here in the first half. Score remains 0-0. Carthage has had two shots on goal so far. North Park has not yet had a shot on goal. They did have one shot, but it trickled wide. So two shots on goal for Carthage. One, a really great opportunity. And here they are with a free kick. They're taking it into the center. It's headed there. I think it's Walker that got her head on it. She chases it, but it is hunted down by Emily LaSalle, who so far for North Park has probably been the player of the game. I mean, it's early, obviously, but she's already made a couple of saves. One very difficult one, and one that was certainly not easy, so she seems to be commanding the box fairly well. Leah Martin brings it down, but does lose out there. There's a foul, good thing, because I think North Park had some numbers going forward there. They had four players in the attacking zone to three or four on Carthage, depending on who got back and how quickly. So Stephanie Mitchell has it now in the middle. Finds Leah Martin. Goes back to Katie Kramer. Katie tries to go far upfield. Juvia Antiveros picks up the leftovers, though. Goes out to that right-hand side. Zyra Solis, I think it was, that was steaming down that right-hand side, but not able to catch up to it. Does come back, but out of bounds. So looks like Solis will take another throw on that far side. Maggie Thom with a really nice turn there. Comes centrally, but Leah Martin picks it up there. She's been having a good game for Carthage so far. Yuvia Antivero's trying to work her magic in the middle of the field. Jenny Garcia pulls it back nicely. She tries to go through the middle to Veronica Walker. It's a little bit of a tough angle for her to get on the ball. Yuvia Antivero's, though, is there for a follow-up. Tries to bring it down and get it into the box. Katie Talons that time with a nice pass back to Solis. Goes upfield and just to the edge of the box there. The keeper's area, for some reason on this field, seems bigger than most pitches. I'm sure it's probably just regulation, but the width of it especially seems awfully large on the Carthage pitch. I'm not sure if that's probably just the way that the football field works and the way that it is laid over the football field. It seems very wide. Kick up field there. Foul right in front of the referee. Worst place to foul, obviously, is standing 3 feet in front of the referee. Probably going to catch that, which he did in this case. So that will be a free kick. But it goes all the way through. Carthage will have the throw. Trying to find a way upfield there. Yuvia Antivero's with a nice play into Jenny Garcia. Pulls it back again. Katie Kramer now making a little run forward. He's a Traxel along the sideline. But now it's with North Park. Sophia Svedberg. Svedberg with a shot. But Stallworth is there. Again, a nice positioning for Ainsley Stallworth, right where she ought to be, and that's exactly where the ball ended up. So some good positioning for her. Yuvia Antivero's tries to bring it down. Veronica Walker tries to go far side, but Maggie Thom was making a run the other direction. North Park again. Svedberg has gotten into the game here in the last few minutes. Kaisa Manson. Holtgard. Oh, I'm sorry, that's actually Ida Elise Elia on that play, and she'll be taking the corner as well, which resulted. Elia lining it up. North Park has 8 players in the box. It comes all the way through, and ooh, it ended up going wide. Wasn't clear who was going to get to that ball. Certainly a danger moment for the Carthage back line, but it did end up going harmlessly wide. So Carthage dodges a bullet there. Certainly wouldn't want to give up the first goal of the game. First goal certainly tonight will probably be pretty important. Carthage has not scored a goal in a couple of games, so they'd really like to get one here in the first half to get them on the right path. A little misplaced pass there. North Park, though, showing some good ball control. Comes in centrally, bounces around there, but has Leah Martin, who got a foot on it, was able to direct it away from the North Park player and into the hands of Ainsley Stallworth. That one gets by the North Park defender. Maggie Thom is on it. She's running. She's got speed. And a shot! Oh, just wide. I'm not sure if the player got a piece of that, or I guess we'll see what the resulting call is. I guess it was not off of the player. It just Must have dribbled just a little bit wide, but Maggie again. That's a couple of shots she's had in this first half. That one, I'm not sure if that'll be a shot on goal necessarily. I think it did just go wide, but it was certainly an opportunity. It was not on goal officially, which I think is correct. But a really strong opportunity nonetheless. Jenny Garcia finds Walker. And Maggie Thom runs onto it again. They're finding some opportunities with her, and she tries to center cross that ball. Ontiveros goes back to Thom, and this time she was offside. They found a few little plays where Veronica Walker or one of the other players has been able to play Maggie Thom through. She's had a couple of runs at the goal. And we've come over half of the first half now. 21-13, 21-10 to go. Carthage having more of the ball and more opportunities in the last couple of minutes, so they seem to be getting stronger as the game goes on. No substitutions yet for Carthage. It looks like North Park is readying a couple of substitutions, but Coach Wilson has so far at least gone with the team that he put out there to start. Other than, of course, Kenzie Zocker, who, as we mentioned, is injured and was just getting that final start. Throw in on the far side. Out of bounds, that'll be a throw into Carthage. So Lise throws it in. Trying to find Walker. Comes all the way through. Katie Kramer goes back up. Maggie Thom is really giving that North Park defense some trouble. She's hustling and had a couple of runs where she's gotten in behind, but just hasn't been able to get the shot quite right yet. Thought North Park was readying some substitutions. Ooh, nice jump through there. Maggie Thom again. Oh! She eluded her defenders, just kind of jumped right past him there. Really nice play. She's really showing some spark. Maggie's a sophomore, as I mentioned. Originally listed on the roster as a defender, but she's really been playing as a striker. Coach likes to move those defenders oftentimes up to strikers. Veronica Walker also listed as a defender, but she's the other major striker on the team. Bounces in front. Played across the front, and North Park is able to clear it. Cyrus Solis, though, try to put it back in. She does, but it goes all the way to the keeper, who picks it out of midair. Now North Park has it. Svedberg tries to go forward. She does. Zyrus Olis, though, with a really strong defensive play in the center. Goal-saving play. North Park trying to put it back in. Svedberg again, but this time a little bit too far. Looks like Carthage is now readying a substitution. We'll see what that'll be on the next stoppage of play. Walker with some nice hold-up play there. Katie Talons goes upfield trying to find Maggie Thom. Really just kind of trying to find an opening there. Looks like we will get that substitution now. Jenny Garcia's going off. Sarah Fitzgibbon coming on now. Sarah has played kind of all over the field as well. She's played in defense. I think she played mostly center back last season and played some fullback outside on the defense this season, and also in some in midfield as she seems to be playing currently. If it's a like-for-like substitution, Jenny Garcia was playing kind of in the middle of midfield. That's maybe where Sarah has ended up. There she is on the ball. Looks like that's where she'll be. Maybe a little bit on the left-hand side. Seems like in that midfield, Leah Martin's playing the deepest she usually does. Then Katie Talons and now Sarah Fitzgibbon are playing just ahead of her. Vivi Ontiveros then is in a more kind of attacking role. Jess Bamer has come on. Olivia Rivera has come on as well. As you can see, Talons has gone off. Jess Bamer, number 10, is a freshman from Schaumburg. She's the second leading scorer for Carthage, so one to watch. She's come on up front there in place of Veronica Walker. So now it's Maggie Thom and Jess Bamer up front. So a sophomore and a freshman as the two strikers. Some promise for the future. As I mentioned, the three. Cyrus Elise has been a regular starter for this team. She's graduating. Jenny Garcia has been a starter off and on, I would say. Here's the free kick now from North Park. Handled by Ainsley Stallworth, no problem there. Jenny Garcia has been a starter fairly often. Yubi Ontiveros also has started this season more often than not. Kenzie Zucker was a regular contributor, certainly during her time here as well. So seniors will certainly be missed. No question about that. But also a lot of good young talent on this Carthage squad, so something for Coach Wilson to build from next season. Not to overlook this season. There's still a few games left, and certainly be looking to get a win here by hook or by crook. After this game, they've got two more games on the road. This is mentioned as their last home game of the season. But they will have two more games in the next week. Saturday, they'll be at Milliken at 5 p.m. And then next Wednesday night, they'll be at Elmhurst, their final game of the season at Elmhurst at 7 o'clock next Wednesday night. And I think if they don't have a win by then, I mean, Elmhurst so far is 0-14 on the season. Here comes North Park. Really nice play there on defense. Lisa Traxel. Excellent play. Fitzgibbon now battling here on this side. As I was mentioning, their last game against Elmhurst. Elmhurst has not yet won a game this season either. In fact, they are 0-14 so far on the season, so Carthage does not want to leave it until then, but if they have to, that should be a promising chance for them to get a win in their final game of the year. That one goes out of bounds. Forsberry. Ariana Lopez there, number 21, has come in for North Park. Cyrus Solis in the center there with a nice play. Get that clear. Leah Martin helps it on further. Nice ball into the center. Battle for it there. Olivia Rivera with a nice play to get it away. She can't quite find her way upfield, but there is a foul there. So that'll be a Carthage free kick. Referee pulls it back, and Katie Kramer lines it up. There's Leah Martin. She tries to come near side, but it does get past the defense and into the arms of keeper Emily LaSalle. Coming up on the 10-minute mark here in the first half, still no score. 11:40 to go. That goal kick comes all the way through. Fitzgibbon now picks it up. Finds Mitchell. North Park does end up with the ball, though. Nice passing in there. Ooh, and a foul called. Megan Tauschek, I think number 28, was the one who was fouled there, or at least by the referee's estimation. So a free kick in a fairly dangerous position, just about 22, 23 yards out, fairly central. Carthage will definitely be setting up a wall here once they get instructions from the referee about where it should go in terms of distance, and their keeper will help direct them where in terms of location. Referee giving some last minute instructions here as he lines up this free kick. Just at the 10-minute mark is an important moment. I think it's Hultgard who's taking that kick, and it does go high over the net. So Stallworth is lining it up under 10 minutes now. Carthage looking to try to find something here at the end of this first half to hopefully go in to halftime with a little lead. That would sure be a big confidence boost for this team that has not scored in a couple of games. As I mentioned, they've been shut out in their last two. And in fact, they've only scored one goal in their last five games. They didn't score in their last two. Their last goal was at Carroll, where they drew 1-1. But before that, they also had two games where they failed to get a goal. So one goal in the last five, they're certainly hunting for a goal, trying to find a way to put that ball in the net. They got to do that tonight. Here comes North Park, though. Dribbles out. Excellent play there by Katie Kramer to get on that ball. Ooh, and almost a counterattack there. Jess Beamer was trying to turn her defender, but couldn't quite get through. But Carthage is looking to spring a counterattack if they can. In these periods where North Park has a little bit more of the ball. Here's Maggie Tom. Ooh, she's tripped. Tripped up there. And that looks like it's going to be a card. Indeed it is. Tom looked like she was going to get through there, and so there was a foul on her. And that was Lena Bogg, the second leading scorer, who received that yellow card. She's a sophomore from Sundbyberg, Sweden. So Bogg with a yellow card. First yellow card of the game. And Carthage will have a free kick. Comes all the way back out. Stephanie Mitchell tries to... Oh, and there was a foul, so that's all moot. Free kick for North Park. Some nice passing there. Kenneth Parker's looked good on the ball. I've not gotten a lot of chances. Just haven't engineered much from it. Mariana Lopez, who goes far side. Hager. There she is on the ball. Again on that far left-hand side. Comes all the way across. Cleared out, though, by Lisa Traxel. Goes back into the middle. And Stallworth off her line quickly to pick that ball up. Looking downfield, they have had some luck. Especially with Maggie Thom. Maggie tries to hold the ball up there, but it does come back the other way. Zyra Solis with a nice interception. Finds Rivera, but it is taken away. And now North Park cycles it around and comes back again. Sophie Svedberg tries to go herself through the middle, doesn't quite come off. Fitzgibbon clears, but Thom is not able to get on it. A little bit of a collision there. That would be a foul. I think that was Olivia Rivera who was going in for a challenge there and I think just tripped her. And went down into the legs of the opponent. I think Lena Bogg is lining up that free kick. Don't believe there was a card there. I think it was just a foul on Rivera. Looked pretty accidental to me anyway. Bogg goes into the center. Stallworth is there though. Right on her line, she makes that catch. Nicely done. Forsberry was right there. Waiting in the wings. There's Beamer. She gets on that ball. Thom can't quite pick it up again. And we're coming up on 5 minutes. Just 5 minutes to go in this first half. What's been a pretty even game. Kind of back and forth. Carthage has 4 shots on goal to only 1 shot on goal for North Park. But overall, the shots are 5-4, so they have been pretty close in terms of overall shots. Although Carthage has been a bit more accurate with theirs. And there's a play on the far side, which goes out of bounds. That was Katie Kramer who made the block over there. And that will be a corner kick. It looks like Marta Holtgard has stepped over to take that. She's a junior from Stockholm, Sweden. Eight North Park players in the box, all very close to the Carthage goal. Comes out to the edge of the box. A little bit strange placement, given that those players were so close to the end line. Comes back into the box. Stallworth, though, is there. She's right there, no problem. Svedberg coming down, ready for a rebound there as well. Had a little more possession, I would say. We'll see what the possession statistics look like at halftime, but seems like they've had the ball a little bit more frequently than Carthage, even though Carthage has more shots on goal so far in the game. Well, the North Park has 2 corners to Carthage's 1 corner. Maggie Thom has gone out. Olivia Crane has come in, so Maggie with a really excellent first half, had a couple of great opportunities. If not for the strong play of the North Park keeper, Maggie would most certainly have a goal tonight. She's had a couple of good opportunities and some really strong runs through the middle. So Carthage now moving into the North Park half with just 3 minutes left on the clock. Some physical play there in the center, no foul. Shoulder to shoulder contact. Nice move there by North Park on the far side. Been moving the ball well in midfield, really. They've had a lot more possession in midfield than Carthage has. Carthage has had a few more kind of through balls that have seen them have more opportunities. But North Park has had more possession, I would say. See if my estimate holds up when we get the halftime statistics in a few minutes. All the way down that far side. Katie Kramer, though, is there. And she makes a nice play to knock the ball off of the North Park defender so that Carthage will have the throw. The back four for Carthage has remained intact this whole half. And they have played well, not allowing much. It goes over the end line again. So that'll be another goal kick with under 2 minutes to play now. Carthage back four. Traxel, Mitchell, Kramer, Solis has been strong. Liberty Rivera now. Trying to find Jess Beamer, who's got good speed up that right-hand side. North Park is forced to knock that ball out of bounds, so Carthage maybe can put something together here. Try to fashion one more opportunity. Cyrus Solis comes centrally. Now it's coming back the other way, 1 minute to go. Leah Martin steps up though and gets in the way. So he's with a block on that side. Another one. And she ends up with possession. So we're winding down on a pretty even half, I would say, overall. Carthage with a few more shots on goal. North Park seemingly with a little bit more of the possession. They have one more chance here. Counting down. Only 10 seconds to go. Probably no chance for either team here. And it does end up with no opportunity. So at the end of the first half, from Art Keller Field in Kenosha, Wisconsin, our score is the Carthage Firebirds 0 and the North Park Vikings 0. We'll be back right after a halftime break. And we are back for the second half here from Art Keller Field in Kenosha, Wisconsin. The score at halftime is 0-0 between North Park and Carthage. The final home game of the year for the Carthage women and senior night, so celebrating our seniors here tonight. Jenny Garcia, Zyra Solis, Kenzie Zacher, Olivia Covelli, Yuvia Ontiveros, Annika Schmidt. All of them, congratulations on a great Carthage career. Statistics are in from the first half and show a very even game, frankly. So far in terms of possession, North Park is leading Carthage, but just 51 to 49%, so very close in terms of overall possession. Carthage is slightly ahead in terms of the shots on goal. Total shots, 5-4, and shots on target, 4-1. So the keeper for North Park, Emily LaSalle, has played a very strong game. She's had 4 saves already in this first half. Just the 1 yellow card in the first half, that was really the only action in terms of what's in the book so far. Lena Bogg, number 18 for North Park, got that yellow card at the 36-34 mark. But Maggie Thom, probably the outstanding performer for Carthage. Maggie had 3 shots, and 2 of those shots were on goal. One of them very close, was a really nice breakaway. It looked like she was going to be able to score on that one, but A nicer play even by Hamley LaSalle, the keeper. So we are underway here in the second half. Carthage now moving from left to right, wearing the red uniforms. North Park going right to left in dark blue or black. I'm not sure which that is, to be honest. We'll say dark blue. I think it looks a little more like dark blue than it does like black. But then again, I'm behind tinted glass. So it is a very cold night. I'm happy to have this tinted glass here in front of me. It's only about 38 degrees. I checked the temperature at halftime, and it had gone under 40 degrees. It's only 38 degrees at the kickoff of the second half. There's Jenny Garcia, one of the seniors, who's back on the field now. It looks like coach has gone back to his starting lineup here. Maggie Thom, the one exception, but she was a sneaky starter there because Kenzie Zucker got the start, even though she's injured here on senior night. Nice story. Maggie Thom came in and played very, very well. Agnes Beck, now their leading scorer. She's kind of on the left-hand side. She's sort of a left wing. We'll see her very well from this position now. And there was an offside on that play. Sophia Svedberg, who had a lot of action in the first half, she's kind of a central attacker, central striker for North Park. Sophie is a freshman from Norway, from Asker, Norway. But getting a lot of minutes up front and a lot of action, too. Only playing well here tonight. Gonna say we might have a lot of viewers from Scandinavia here tonight, but of course with the time difference, it's about 3 o'clock in the morning, I think, in Scandinavia now, so probably not a prime viewing time, although maybe some Swedish parents are tuned in or will be watching this game at some point. North Park goes far into the corner. There it is, eventually dug out, and a shot. Oh, what a save by Ainsley Stallworth. The ball looked like it was going to go over the end line, but then didn't, and it was put out front. And I think that was Svedberg who was right there in front. And wow, that was a close call. Luckily, Ainsley Stallworth came out of halftime alert. North Park now into the center again. That one's booted away. That was a strange play. It looked like it was for sure headed out of bounds, and then somehow the North Park player dug it out there and got it right out in front for an open shot, but Stallworth was in the right place at the right time. So now Carthage will have a throw-in on that far side. Just about 15 yards inside of the North Park zone. Maggie Thom on that far side and trying to dig something out of the corner, but it does go out of bounds. Some nice defensive play over there. And that'll be a goal kick, which was taken short. And North Park will try to work it out from the back and not able to do that, so that'll be a throw-in here on this side. Zyra Solis has played the entire game so far. First half, Traxel, Solis, Martin, Mitchell, and Kramer all played 45 minutes. Maggie Thom played 41 minutes. Of course, she was very active when she was in there. Svedberg now, she tries to go far side. It's Holtgard. Has to come back across, but nobody was making the run. Dartmouth Park has done a nice job, as I mentioned in the first half, of really controlling that ball in midfield. Svedberg now up front trying to go through. Carthage defense collapses there in the middle and is able to repel the North Park attack. Beck throws it in. She gets it back. Goes centrally. Comes all the way across. And a shot there from distance. That was Kaisa Manson. Stallworth with a long kick. Juvia Ontiveros has it there. Maggie Thom now giving a little chase. She almost is able to pick it off of her defender, but not quite. It does come all the way through, though. Madeline Hager now back on this side to Beck. Svedberg. Intercepted by Garcia. There's Walker. Maggie Thom. Tried to sneak it through the middle there. Kind of the North Park defense was collapsing in the center, and Maggie Thom was trying to run right down the middle. Veronica Walker tried to ease it through there, but wasn't quite able to do it. Traxel. Oh, but she was offside on the return ball there. Had that a couple times now where the player throwing it in gets the ball back, but they are in an offside position once they get that ball back, so that'll be a free kick on the far side. Holtgard is over there to take it, I think it is. So these two teams, as you may have seen at halftime, our producer flashed the standings of the CCIW thus far this season up on the screen, and these two teams very similar in terms of their conference record. Carthage currently in eighth place out of nine in the CCIW conference, and North Park is in seventh, just above them. If Carthage were to win this game, then the two teams would have identical CCIW records, conference records. So they'd be even as far as the conference season goes on the season. Although North Park has a slightly better overall record on the year. And they'll have a corner kick. So the first corner of the second half comes almost 10 minutes in, and that's to North Park. Here is that corner. It's right into the center. Was headed there. I think that was Lena Bogg. She's not able to get a goalward. Shot from distance. And that goes over the crossbar. And in fact, hits the upright for the football field. Stallworth looked for a minute like she was a little bit concerned about that shot. But it did end up going well over the net. Park now, spending some time in that Carthage zone. Good clear by Katie Kramer. Throw in though by North Park, quickly. Tried to go back to back, but did not quite come off, so that'll be a Carthage throw. There's Veronica Walker. Oh, she tries to get it through the top mom, but it ends up hitting her in the back. Here comes Beck the other way. It's down in that deep corner now. North Park does pick it up there. Back centrally. Nice move across, and a shot with the left foot. What stalwart is there? Those Ida Elise Ayla? Ayla? Veronica Walker gets ahead on it there, but not able to connect. Garcia. Here goes Traxel. Tripped up there, but no foul. She'll need to get back now into position. Jenny Garcia's dropped back there to cover her on the left side of defense. Wise play from a senior. Now in the corner, that's Kaisa Manson. Svedberg playing a little two-person game there. Tries to cross it all the way across, but Stallworth is alert on her near post. So we played over 10 minutes here so far in the second half, still 0-0. No score here so far tonight. Carthage, as I mentioned, has gone two games without a goal. Looking for some production up front. Hard to win if you can't score, that's for sure. Carthage, of course, lost a lot of production when Morgan Verbetten graduated. As I mentioned, Carthage won this tilt last season 5-2, was it, or 5-1? 5-2 it was. There's a header in. Stallworth is there. Carthage won it 5-2, but four of those goals came from Morgan Verbetten, who has since graduated, who was their leading scorer last season. Now is playing as a graduate assistant, or as a graduate student, I should say. I think she has some eligibility still, but she showed up on the roster for North Central. Surprise, I think, to at least to me. I'm sure the girls probably knew that, or the coaches knew that as well, I'm sure. It was nice to see her again. Ball bounces Carthage's way, but nobody's there to pick it up. And it looks like we have a bit of an injury here, possibly. One of the North Park players is a little slow to get to her feet. Lena Bogg, she's been in a lot of the center of a lot of things so far tonight. She's very active in the midfield, and looks like she's just fine. She's up and walking it off. Training staff comes out just to double check. Referee, you know, always don't want to be, can't be too careful, I guess, in these kinds of situations, right? You always want to make sure that there's no serious injury. You don't want to jeopardize anyone's safety. Referee has gone over to talk to the coaching staffs. Couple of groupings of players on the field, kind of discussing things. As I mentioned, Carthage has two away games coming up. Saturday they'll be at Milliken at 5 p.m. and next Wednesday night, their final game of the season at Elmhurst. That game is at 7 p.m. next Wednesday night at Elmhurst College down in Illinois. Referee getting things situated here, ready for a restart. It looks like he's going to drop it in front of the North Park keeper, Emily LaSalle. He does. And we have a game moving again after a short injury timeout. The North Park player came right back on the field, so no serious injury. There's a foul. Again, good to see. Jenny Garcia now lining up that free kick. Carthage will certainly miss her senior leadership. She's been a really nice player for us this season, and that one trickles out of bounds. So a good break there for Carthage. North Park could not quite control it. That was Lena Bogg, I think, who had just gone to the sideline to check an injury, and she's okay. She's back in. She lost that ball out of bounds. So Carthage will have a free corner kick here. From this near corner, Garcia will take it. Bounces around. Keeper did not get on it. Yuvia Tavares was close. Jenny Garcia comes back at it. Took it with her left foot and curled it too far to the near side of the goal. North Park having a little more of the shot action here in the second half. They're now leading 9-6 in overall shots and 5-4 in shots on goal as well. Carthage was leading in those categories in the first half, and North Park has picked it up here. Leah Martin with a nice play. She drops back. That'll be a Carthage ball. Agnes Beck thought should have been a North Park ball. Veronica Walker with a nice turn there. She uses her body well to pick that ball up and not able to cross it. It does go out of bounds. So that'll be a goal kick to North Park. Under 30 minutes now to play in this one. 29 minutes to play. Still 0-0. Who will be first to make the breakthrough? And will that be enough to hold up? Neither one of these teams scoring too much this season. So far on the season, North Park has 17 goals against 26 against. Carthage only with 9 goals so far this season. Pops through. But LaSalle is out and on top of it quickly. She's been very good so far in this game. Svedberg. Try to go through there, but Stallworth is alert. She finally picks it up. Carthage doesn't play out for the back very much. They seem to like to try to go long and to try to find a ball into Veronica Walker if possible and then get one of the other quick strikers running off of her. This ball comes through. Lisa Traxel with a nice play there. Tries to move it forward, but it does end up going out of bounds. Kaisa Manson stepping forward to take that throw, which she does. Svedberg now in the middle. Tries a little reverse ball. North Park has possession. Veronica Walker with a little defensive pressure there. Maggie Thom now trying to run it down. But North Park calmly collects it and takes it back upfield. Leah Martin, though, is there. gets it back. Veronica Walker with a nice angle there to get that ball past her defender. Goes after it. That'll be a Carthage throw. So some nice work there by Veronica Walker to keep that ball alive. To nice angled layoff there and chases it down and forces the error. Into the corner to Thom. Yuyan Taveras battling there but not able to get it. It is another throw in here. Lisa Traxel is over there to take it. She takes it quickly. Walker goes right back to Traxel. Finds Garcia, who crosses it. Yuvian Antiveros is there. Plays it back to Solis, who lifts it into the center. Maggie Thom couldn't quite get a head on it. I'm not sure if it ended up getting it with a shoulder, with a chest maybe, but not able to get her head on it. So an opportunity, a good cross there by from Zyra Solis from pretty deep. There she is again. Slip there by Katie Talons. Not sure what the call was. I think it was a foul there. Katie Talons, it just sort of slipped there, I think, maybe, but ended up being a foul. Lena Bogg now, she's lining this up. Goes down the middle. Leah Martin is there, though. No problem with the clearance. Clears it out of bounds. Agnes Beck throws it in. Durakovic. Now Svedberg, she lines up a shot. And it does go over. Once again, about 25 yards out or so. Carthage would probably be content with shots from that kind of distance. It's not too dangerous. Although you never know, somebody could really connect with one. But that one did not end up going on goal. So under 25 to play now. Coming up on the halfway point of the second half. Nice defensive play there by Yuvian Taveros to get that ball back. And she gets through. Maggie Thom gets through too. Veronica Walker now tries to return it to Taveros, but wasn't quite ready for that pass, I don't think, or just hadn't beaten her defender yet. There was still a defender in front of her. So we're not able to take advantage of the numbers there. Bit of a collision there in midfield. No foul. Everybody's okay. Maggie Thom goes running after that ball. Carthage throw. Kovic gets it back. Goes forward. Stephanie Mitchell steps up, though, nicely. Vinnie Garcia with the interception there. She's had a good game in midfield. This time, Maggie Thom with a nice little move to get it past her defender. And North Park is forced to just knock it out of bounds there. But again, a good idea and some good hustle from Carthage. Comes all the way back out of bounds. Lisa Traxel will take it again. There's Thom again. Traxel centers it, crosses it. Getting my hockey and soccer terminology messed up. It's really more of a cross than a centering pass, I guess. Although, very similar. Carthage is getting some opportunities here, just not quite able to get that ball into dangerous positions once they get in that final third. And it does eventually go out of bounds to North Park on that far side. We're under halfway now, coming up on 20 minutes. So we're going to have some substitutions here. Svedberg goes off. Gustafsson comes on for North Park. Gradin comes on, and Helia comes back off. I think there may have been a substitution for Carthage, too. We'll see here. Holgaard comes off. Cifuentes comes on. And it looks like Sarah Fitzgibbon has come on for Carthage. Jenny Garcia was the player making way there. So Fitzgibbon for Garcia for Carthage. Free kick now, though, for North Park in their Carthage half. Across the front of the goal. Ooh, it did bounce there. Agnes Beck, their leading scorer, was right there at the back post and looked like she was very close to being able to poke that ball in. Right at the 20-minute mark, right, basically. So it's getting to be crunch time now. The final 20 minutes of the final home game of the season. Carthage trying to get a win on senior night, as you always want to try to do for those graduating seniors so they can have one last win, taste of a victory here at home. It'll be especially sweet for these seniors who have not yet had a victory at home to have one here tonight. 20 minutes left. Both teams have threatened tonight, but nobody able to yet get on the score sheet. North Park with a throw-in. And again, out of bounds. Another throw-in. Veronica Walker doing her defensive work. Ball stays in bounds. Comes across. Nice play by Katie Kramer. Katie's had a very strong game tonight. Katie's a junior from St. Joseph, Illinois. So that'll be a Carthage free kick. Referee steams upfield. Sarah Fitzgibbon takes it. Bounces centrally, but it's cleared out. Fitzgibbon follows it up, though. Lisa Traxel into the center. Maggie Thom had a beat on it, but lost her footing. Cyrus Solis now trying to find Katie Talons up this right-hand side. Katie hasn't been in the game too much tonight, as much as maybe she usually is. Our leading scorer on the season so far. Stephanie Mitchell now finds Fitzgibbon, finds Martin. Katie Talons back to Zyra Solis, back to Katie Talons. Nice play there. Talons follows it up. Gibbon with a nice move in the center of midfield. Nice footwork. Goes to Lisa Traxel. Comes near side now. It's Agnes Beck. Centrally. Madeline Hager. Only as far as Kaya Manson. Kaisa Manson, sorry. Nice play there, Lynn Graydon. And that'll be a goal kick. Looks like a couple of more substitutions coming in here. Looks like Walker is going off and Olivia Rivera is coming on. So Veronica Walker for Carthage off. Olivia Rivera on. That Katie Talons will move up into that center spot. Kaisa Manson, as you can see, they're going off. Ariana Lopez coming on. Those were the two changes. So now it's Maggie Thom and Katie Talons up front. Veronica Walker getting a break. Olivia Rodriguez. Rivera, I'm sorry, Olivia Rivera. Olivia's a freshman from Lockport, Illinois. Nice crossing ball there by North Park. Trying to pass it around there, but not finding a way through. Sarah Fitzgibbon with a nice play. Katie Talons now with a little run. She's got some space. Gets past the defender, and she shoots. And it bounces into the hands of the keeper, Emily LaSalle there. But nice run by Katie Talons. Maggie Thom was with her, but wasn't a clear angle for a pass there. Forces a save out of the keeper. So good shot on goal there for Carthage. Shots on goal now 6-5 in favor of Carthage. Although overall 10-8. North Park has the most total shots. Now North Park has it again. Under 15 minutes to play now. North Park trying to find their way through. Referee does not call any kind of an infraction there. North Park now has it centrally, but it's cleared out there. Nicely done by Stephanie Mitchell. Viviana Taveros tries to sneak around there, but it does end up going out of bounds, or it looks like that'll be a Carthage throw. So Lista Taveros with a nice little move there. She tries to go up the sideline. There's a foul, looks like. So that'll be a Carthage free kick, if I'm not mistaken. Indeed it is. Katie Kramer's come over to take that free kick. She takes it. Doesn't get into the danger area. Yeah, Taveros trying to get that ball in midfield, but it's taken away. Step up there by the Carthage defense, although North Park gets it back. There's a tangle there, but no foul. And it goes out of bounds for a North Park throw. Nice little give and go there. Into the center. And she's open. And a save by Stallworth. And another save by Stallworth. So a real opportunity there for North Park. And it goes begging. There's Lisa Gustafsson, the freshman from Sweden, who got in there and got a shot up, but Ainsley Stallworth with a real nice save. Right in the center of the goal. So now the shots on goal are even at 6-6. Each keeper with six saves on the night. That's really impressive. Ainsley Stallworth and Emma LaSalle. Emma's a sophomore from Olivet, Michigan, and Ainsley is a freshman from Fresno, California. Battle down here. And Beck and Solis. Solis comes away with it, though. Katie Talons with some good hustle. Can't quite get in front of her defender. Nice move down the side there. That's Forsberry. And it goes out for a corner kick. So a corner kick here with just 10 minutes to play. This will be the fourth overall corner from North Park in the game. Goes centrally. Takes a bounce there. There's a shot. Goes into the goal, but that was, there was a foul on the play, or referee spotted a foul before the shot was taken. So lucky for Carthage there. There was a foul, though it looks like they had all stopped playing for the whistle, so it may not have gone in if it was played at full speed. So Elise takes the safe play out of bounds. Carthage would hate to give up a goal here in the last 10 minutes of the game. Either team would hate to give up a goal here. But both teams really looking for a win, needing a win. North Park with just the one conference win so far this season. Carthage yet to get on the board in the conference. Sarah Fitzgibbon now picks up that loose ball. It's knocked out of bounds, but that'll be a Carthage throw. Lisa Traxel comes up to take it quickly. Just over 8 minutes now to play in this one. Still no score. Looking for a goal here from the Carthage Firebirds. Try to send off the seniors with a win. Foul there. North Park free kick. Lena Bogg is lining up. She's a really excellent player. Comes centrally. Durkovic. Battling it out there with Leah Martin. As it coming back to the North Park player. Trying to find a way through. Leah Martin is there, though, and is able to knock it out. She's been really fundamentally important in that central defensive midfielder role, Leah Martin, throughout the season, really, but especially tonight. Leah is a sophomore from Highlands Ranch, Colorado, so in her second season, really making her presence felt. I'm sure she'll be a strong player for us in seasons to come. She's really carving out a role for herself as a kind of defensive stopper back there. Park looking for that opportunity. Here they all with the ball. Svedberg. Try to go through there, just trying to get something through, but Carthage knocks it away. Forsberry. There's a foul. Under six. Carthage showing a little bit of urgency here, hoping to be able to get at least one more chance, if not a couple more chances here. Would sure be nice. Olivia Rivera now tries to turn it upfield. There's Martin. Nice sidestep. She goes far side. Nice ball. And Carthage has a little run here, and there's a foul, and it is. It's a penalty. It is a penalty. The referee has pointed to the spot. And has called the penalty. I think that was Lisa Traxel who was running down that left side. And she was fouled. So that will be a penalty kick for Carthage here with just over 5 minutes to play. The referee conferring with the assistant referee. And it looks like Leah Martin is stepping up here. Not sure if she's going to take that free kick or not. Leah does not have a goal yet on the season. She has 3 shots on goal. This would be her first goal of the year and would certainly put Carthage in the driver's seat to win this game. So a big play, the biggest play of the night. Clear foul on that far side. And Carthage will have a penalty kick. Sophia Svedberg was guilty of that foul, 84th minute. Oh no, it was Hultgard. And Leah Martin steps up. Shot. And a goal! Leah Martin. You heard it there from the PA announcer, Leah Martin, with her first goal of the season. Leah's a sophomore, as I mentioned, from Highlands Ranch, Colorado, just highlighting her just a minute ago for her great defensive play. And she steps up and knocks in the penalty. One substitution here. It looks like Veronica Walker has come back on for Yuvia Ontivero. So a little bit more strength up front, I guess, is what coach is going for there. So with just 5 minutes to play, Carthage gets on the board and now leads 1-0. This would be a huge win for them, for the seniors, for their CCIW place. Veronica Walker hustling down there, putting pressure on the defense. And Lena Bogg is forced to just put it out of bounds there. Carthage will be in no big hurry, although they do send it in pretty quickly. Maggie Thom is over there along with Veronica Walker. Carthage, you'd imagine, will be playing this pretty defensively from here on out, trying to secure those points, although looks like Katie Talon's here, trying to find Rivera. There's Martin, the goal scorer. Far side now. Lisa Traxel, who was making that run, who drew the penalty. Here she is again. And she was offside on that one. A lot of protestations from the North Park players on that one. Felt she was offside, and the referee agreed. North Park now in kind of desperation mode, trying to find that equalizer. North Park throws it in. The battle for the ball down there, and a foul is called. And so that'll be a Carthage free kick. So with 3 minutes and 15 seconds to go, Carthage has a free kick deep in their own zone. They're now up 1-0 on that important penalty kick goal at the 84-51 mark with just over 5 minutes to play in this one. Carthage finally gets on the board. Lisa Traxel made a really nice run down the left-hand side. She was fouled in the box. And Leah Martin stepped up and put it away just to the goalkeeper's right. Just beyond her reach. A very nicely, calmly taken penalty. There's a... not sure if that's a free kick or a throw-in. We'll see here. Looks like it is a throw-in. The referee has called it back. It was a free kick, not a throw-in. That was the confusion there. So they'll line this up. They put players in the box. It's only 2 minutes left to play. In a hurry to get going, Carthage trying to play some group defense there, and they do. Veronica Walker now has some space here. She smartly plays it upfield, and North Park has to play it out of bounds. So Carthage under 2 minutes. Take their time a little bit here. Cyrus Solis throws it in. Walker holds it up. Battles for it. And a foul. Excellent hustle there, Veronica Walker, just putting the pressure on the North Park defense. Referee urging the Carthage players to take that free kick. It's under a minute and a half to go now. Sarah Fitzgibbon lumps it into the center. It goes beyond the pack and out of bounds. North Park's keeper, Emily LaSalle, is rushing, trying to get a ball out. She does very quickly. Just over a minute and 10 to play. North Park upfield. That ball go out of bounds. So Lise will throw it back in. Off North Park again. Under a minute now. So it looks like Carthage may get their first win of the season. It's exciting stuff. Booted clear there. Emily LaSalle picks it up. Tries to go deep downfield. Katie Talons tries to head it back in that direction. North Park picks it up though. Will they have one more chance here? It comes into the middle. Nice play, Stephanie Mitchell, to get that one away. Veronica Walker, good hustle. She's really been instrumental in these last couple of minutes. Referee plays advantage. Carthage. Olivia Rivera. It goes off the end line. And that's a win for the Carthage Firebirds. Congratulations to our seniors, our five seniors graduating tonight. A big win here at home on senior night. Their first of the season. That puts Carthage to 1-7-5, 1-4-1 in the CCIW. North Park with a loss will go to 3-9-2, 1-4-1 also in the CCIW. So these two teams are now tied in CCIW play. So congratulations to our seniors. Great careers here at Carthage, their last home game. Carthage, as we said, away on Saturday night to Milligan and on next Wednesday to Elmhurst, their final two games of the season. So they'll hope to end it on a high note. So from Art Keller Field in Kenosha, Wisconsin, I'm John Bruning on behalf of our production staff. Thank you very much, and we'll see you back here again next season. Good night.
Firebird fans, with this win, it's time to ring the victory bell. Please direct your attention to the scoreboard where a soccer team member will ring the bell. Say it with me, ring the bell. Fans, thank you for attending today's game and for your continued support of Carthage Athletics. Please drive home safely.